Welcome back to the tutorial about the function blocks of the FlexiSoft Motion Control Module Mock 1. In this video, we will take a look at the function block Speed Crosscheck. This function block compares the speed values from two different signal sources. This serves a higher level of safety, particularly when working with non-safe encoders. Let's go on the Mock 1 logic editor. We have already placed the function block Speed Crosscheck in the configuration area. From the inputs motion in 1 and motion in 2, the function block receives all information provided by the encoders. The output motion out provides the checked motion data. The given information can be used in another function block. Monitor status indicates whether the speed crosscheck function has failed. If an error occurs, the status bit changes to 0. The output check done switches to 1 when a crosscheck is performed for the first time and switches back to 0 if one of the motion in data is invalid. In the next step, we will connect encoders with the inputs of the function block. You can find the encoders under inputs in the cluster Mock 1 encoder. In our example, we select one sine cos encoder and one SSI encoder. Now we connect the signals of the encoders with the inputs motion in 1 and motion in 2. As you already learned in the last videos, we can open the configuration menu by double-clicking on the function block. First, we have to apply the values which we have defined in the encoder settings before. In the next tab, Speed Crosscheck Mode, you are able to determine how the speed values are compared. If the parameter No Speed Comparison is activated, the speed values will not be cross-checked. If the Speed Crosscheck Mode is activated, a speed crosscheck will be performed. Depending on the set mode, the speed difference is determined with or without sign. The function interpolation mode is not relevant for this tutorial. In the next tab Speed Crosscheck Limits, the tolerance limits for the speed crosscheck are defined. With the parameter Speed Difference Tolerance Level, the absolute permissible difference of the speed values from motion in 1 and motion in 2 can be defined. The permissible relative speed difference can be set with the parameter Speed Ratio Tolerance Levels. The absolute speed difference will be checked first. Only if this value is exceeded, the relative speed difference is evaluated. This helps to avoid tolerance errors, which are caused of too small relative tolerance limits during low speeds. Furthermore, it is possible to define two additional inputs. This can be used to enable higher speed ratio tolerance levels for a specific time and situation. With the settings in Speed Ratio Tolerance Level 2 and 3, you can define a maximum time limit in which the speed ratio tolerance levels should be active. Within the tab Speed Output Mode, you can define how the output motion out should be determined and set. There are three different options to choose: Speed of Motion 1, Greater speed from motion 1 or motion 2, and mean speed of motion 1 and motion 2. Speed output mode with the option Speed of motion 1 is usually selected when there is a leading encoder with a higher resolution and a second encoder that is only used for plausibility checks. The option Greater speed of motion 1 or motion 2 should be selected if the higher value from two encoders is to be used for further evaluation. For example, the speed of the outer wheel of an AGV is of relevance during cornering. With the setting mean speed of motion 1 and motion 2, the average speed of the inputs motion in 1 and motion in 2 are calculated. In the tab Reset, you can activate the optional reset input. This makes it possible to reset a fault condition using an external signal. With Inhibit Error Indication, an additional input can be used to prevent an entry in the diagnostics history if a failed speed crosscheck is not relevant for diagnostic purposes. And the last tab, Encoder Reliability Monitor, enables a check to establish whether the signals of the encoders were reliable or not, for example, because of a damage during standstill. To make sure that the encoder signals are still reliable, the motion in speed needs to cross the defined speed threshold minimums once during a max time interval. Thank you for watching this tutorial about the function block Speed Crosscheck. You have now learned all relevant functionalities and how to configure the various parameters in the FlexiSoft Designer. The next video will handle the configuration of the function block Speed Monitor.